the murder victims, I believe we just had to see all of y'all here with us at this time. What our fathers do, he needs no introduction. Dr. Butler, let us receive him. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. To my pastor, Pastor Dick, to Joan, Reverend and Mrs. Brown. I'm glad to give you a new name.
Amen.
Amen. To all the deacons, to all the mothers, first ladies. Amen. And once again, friends, we pray no enemy. Amen. No enemy. Amen. I said, Lord, nobody but the devil. We don't want to give them no credit. Amen. But we praise the Lord for all the reasons.
Amen.
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 It's another opportunity once again to just be able to say a word. The drag everything I was looking at. I said, this whole big Bible, I'm not glad I can't get that.
Preach, baby.
Yeah, I got my five sermons and then I said, I still don't know which one. So I thank the Lord just gave it to me.
Amen.
So we're just going to go on with what He's giving me, all right?
That's right.
So we just bless you, though. Amen. Thank God for the singers and all them.
All right now.
Amen. They sung so greatly, I don't think I'm going to try to sing that today. Amen. I just go on.
All right,
and try to present the word.
All right now.
Amen, amen. Wherever you're going to be short. Then we're going to sit there for and try to think of what it is.
Amen.
Amen, amen. Amen. Okay. Do that. Amen. Since we are traveling on our way home, amen, this old world is not our home, is it right?
All right now.
So we are traveling on our way home.
On our way home.
So I sang a little bit of Fixing Jesus. Fix it like you said you would.
Right.
I'm on my way home.
All right.
On my way home.
Oh,
Exodus, the third chapter. And I'm not going to try the whole year long.
All right now.
But I find out that there is a need for the Lord to fix it. In this land where we live. Well, he had to fix it for years ago. And he can fix it for you and I today. Fix the Jesus. Like you said to me.
All right now.
The third chapter of Exodus. Just a few verses I read. When you get a say amen.
Amen.
Now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law.
Yeah.
Yeah, the priest of Midian. And he led the flock by the backside of the devil.
Yeah.
And came to the mountain of God, even to Hebron.
Yeah.
And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire.
Well.
Out of the midst of the bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed.
Well,
and Moses said, I will now turn
aside
and see this great sight, why the bush is not burned. And when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see, God called unto him out of the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. And he said, here am I.
All right.
Yeah, I just stop right there. What I want to talk about today, do you see God in your calling?
Come on, Rabbi. Come on, Rabbi. Come on.
Do you see God in your calling? He calls, somebody say, by the thunder. Trumpet sound within my soul.
Yeah.
I ain't got long to stay here. But he does call us.
Yes,
sir. And by him calling us, we ought to be able to recognize
him.
By him calling, I shouldn't even know a gift from a natural man. Yes, he called Samuel one day. And Samuel went to, and said, what do you want?
What do you want?
He said, well, I didn't call. So he said, he went on back and lay down again. And the Lord called him again. And he went in and said, what do you want? You called me. He said, no, I didn't call you. And he said, well, I tell you what to do. The next time he called, he said, yes, Lord. So he went and laid down again, and the Lord called him. And he let the Lord know that he heard him. God called you, and he wants you to recognize him. When you recognize him, there ought to be a change taking place. In your life. You ought not see the same old things. You ought not want to act the same old way. You ought to want to have a brand new song, a brand new prayer, a brand new conversation. I've been called by the Master, and I have to answer him. Let him know I recognize his calling. And by recognizing his calling, I have a move that I must make.